So hello friends, today we are going to see about components, and with components we also have to going to see what is interface design for the components. So before going to the slide, I just want to elaborate on these things. This is just paint application that available in Windows. Let's say suppose this is your component. And this component is what we can say file processing component, we say. File processing component. So the file processing component, if you go with a rough architecture of this, what we can say, rough design of the component given by UML, this component can be shown like this. Okay, so we have the component, which is file processing component, and this file processing component need to realize some interface. So whenever it's actually realizes the interface, there are different type of interfaces we have said. This is the first interface we are going to realize interface. Let's consider this is the second realize interface, or the implemented interface, and consider this is the third realize interface by the same file processing component. And let's connect this with the file processing component. Okay. So this is what you can say you are having here 1, 2 and 3. So these three components, these three interfaces, connectors what they call, is actually implemented by this file processing component. So what are the operations in file processing components? If you go with the operations in file processing component, let's talk about the operation. What are the operation? We have the first operation as a new, second is absent, save, third operation is save as, fourth operation may be open. Okay, then like you are having this file processing component, you are a new file, you can save that file, you can save this file as, you can open the existing file, or you can say send the file, send to someone. This is what we call as a share view with email or something. So we can say share and likewise. So these are the operations of file processing components which are required to be realized in these interfaces. So these interfaces, if you go with these interfaces, are actually, if we consider this interface, you can say consumed by the user. So this consumption is generally shown with a simple thing, what we call as this as a receptor. Okay, I'm making this size more bigger so you will get the thing. So here you are having a receptor, and this receptor means it receives the thing. So this whatever input is given to this, and this input is, say for example, when someone click on the new button, you get the new. Yes, when someone click on the save button, it get this save. When someone click on the save as button, accordingly it open the new interface, and likewise. And here your actor is there who is actually having this interfaces, let's say reaction. So this is the first interface. This is called as explicit interface because actor is directly entering input into this realize interface or the connector. Okay, while this realize interface is having all these operations available, okay, with shortcuts and other thing via this component. Okay, component is a processing logic, and this new save as, open share is just what you can say the given idea to this actor, so that actor will know what operation he or she want to you can say execute on the component. Only 19 people are joined, 8. Those who are not joined, ask them to join because mail is already sent to all the participants. Okay, so here we are having this components and other things. So now when this user is inputting these things, and all those inputs are actually processed by this file component, and this component is a part of a bigger system. Now this is an explicit input where user is actually giving the input via keyboard. We are considering this input is given by keyboard, and likewise our user may have the pointer input. Let's call this as a keyboard, so we are saying this as a K input, this as a pointer. So we are saying, when we say pointer devices, we are considering touch screen, we are also considering the mouse. Okay, so here you are once again having this user. Okay, and this user is once again giving what we can say input to the interface using mouse or pointer devices. So when you are using the command line or keyboard, we generally call this as a command line user interface or CUI. Okay, CUI. So actually user required to type the commands, and accordingly those commands will get executed, or user required to use the keyboard instead of using the pointer devices. When you are using the specifically pointer devices, it is called as graphical user interface or GUI. Okay, it is called as graphical user interface. For example, when you go right now, here you are having these symbols. What these symbols, I want to change the color. So I have this color thing. What this? This is a graphical user interface. But if I need to write down the color name, then it is a command line user interface. Okay, because to change color here, I am not using any keyboard. I am using only the pointer device, that is mouse. But to change something, I am using graphical user interface. So this is the two interfaces that are generally used. These are the two type of interfaces. This is called as explicit. Then there is an implicit interface technique. Now this implicit interface for any component are of two type. One is where user require to consciously give the input. For example, gesture recognition. Okay, so user will make certain signs to the thing. For example, user can show like this. You can say is arrow, and then computer will scan this image and will say, okay, he is showing the victory sign, means there is something, a good thing is happened. Or user can simply blink his eye one time or two time, and there is a lookup table, that is one blink of eye means open Microsoft Office, two blinks of eye means open Paint application, three blinks of eye means open something like that. So accordingly operating system will observe the user. But here user is neither using any pointer device, okay, means mouse or touch screen, or user is not using nor using any typing devices like your keyboard. Instead, the computer is observing the user through its camera, and then that image get processed for the particular type of input, and once that input is identified, accordingly action takes place. Okay, so this type of user interface is called as implicit user interface. But again, implicit user interface of two type. Here user is giving intentional or conscious input to the computer. For example, let's say suppose if I want to if the computer want to authenticate the user, so user have to go before the computer. Okay, that is, user have to stand before the computer and have to show his left or right eye to the computer camera, where camera will get the picture of this eye, and then that picture get processed into a histogram. Okay, and that histogram is compared with already stored histogram of the eye image, and if it matches, it says, okay, you are the user, you can log in. So no pointer device is used, no keyboard is used, but still interfacing is there. So interface is what? The way of communication. But here user is giving this iris or his eye thing consciously to enter into the system. Face recognition system, you have to put your face before the camera. Camera will scan your face and then allow you to log in into your system. That is what we call as a face recognition system. and that is what we can say the one type of interface. But there is another implicit interface, and that is where user won't require to consciously give any input to the device. The device which without conscious effort from a user can observe the user's behavior or the environment and can make a decision and proceed further with certain type of action is called as smart device. The computer also use the machine learning. In that case, a computer will observe, or artificial intelligence interfacing program will observe your sadness, the percentage of your sadness, it will automatically open a particular channel and play the song or a video or whatever that you usually like to see whenever you are sad. But let's say suppose you are sad, your TV is artificially intelligent, so it's have the implicit interface, it's observe your sadness and it started playing the song. But at the same time, it's you give some different action, you make some different face. The TV's AI program, interfacing program, automatically detect that you are not interested right now in listening or watching the TV, and it will shut itself down. So here you are not giving any input consciously, okay, or some effort to the TV. TV is observing you, and based on that, it is actually operating. So this is called as implicit SCI, implicit human computer interaction or interfaces. So when we are having explicit interface, we are having keyboard interface and pointer interface, and when you are having implicit interface, we are having conscious interfacing, implicit conscious and implicit non-conscious interfaces. Now these implicit non-conscious interfaces are generally used in the components which are called as IoT, Internet of Things, where sensors actually sense the data and then data get calculated, and likewise. So these sensors, for example, if you are having a weight sensor, this weight sensor can sense the weight of the thing, and based on that can identify whether the object on the floor is an animal, a man or vehicle. Okay. For example, if it is a 2 or 3 ton, obviously you are not going to get an elephant everywhere in the city. So it must have to be a vehicle like that. So based on that, you can say these sensor networks uses non-conscious, implicit interfaces, and the components are the processing elements which actually get these inputs and process them further into a meaningful output. And so when we are seeing the component design and interface design, we must have to be very careful about which type of interface we exactly want for our component. For example, for a notepad, having an implicit interface is of no use. For a simple, or you can say a person like you and me, who are not having any physical handicap. But let's say suppose a person is physical handicap, okay, so this person can't type something. You can use pointer, but if this person even not having the ability to use the pointer devices in an explicit interface, in such way you can go for the conscious implicit interface, where the user required to do some conscious movements which get observed by the component or your system, and the system then accordingly act. For example, let's say suppose a person like late scientist Stephen Hawking, okay, who can't move from his a chair, and he want to play some presentation to the users, okay. So what he simply have to sit before the computer and have to for the presentation, he must have to say one left eye blink. Okay, so when left eye blink, that means start presentation. Right eye blink means next slide. Both eye blinks means they read the presentation. So what this system simple say that whenever the person okay, a physically handicapped person is doing this blinking, it automatically observes that. But here the user need to consciously give this input to the system. Morse code is the best example for this. For example, if you use the Morse code for giving input to the computer, then one blink of eye means a continuous blink, two blinks of left eye means you can say left double click of mouse, right wink of the eye means right button is click, and likewise, and accordingly it will happen. So when we are seeing this interface and component, we are actually talking about these two. But I have shown here the explicit part of the interface. I have shown here the explicit part of the interface toys, but implicit I have shown only once here. Okay, but actually why I showed implicit one, because generally when we go for any application development, if not asked by the end user or the customer, implicit human computer interaction mechanism or interfaces are generally not implemented because they cost too much for the implementation. Okay, so we generally stick ourselves with a command line user interface or with the graphical user interface. But because of this new pandemic of the COVID-19, we require to think on this, because we require not to touch the system. Because say suppose you use a computer, someone else is using that computer after you, someone else is using that computer after that person. And if a group happens to use the same machine, and if one person get the COVID, then in that case, the explicit user interface can cause, you know what, a gutter dam. It is what you can say the danger. Yes. So here, as a user, you should have to consider, as a developer, you should have to consider the way of using implicit human computer interface. For example, you are having a Google Assistant. Instead of typing anything on your smartphone, you can simply say search for these things. Yes, and it automatically search. What is it? Conscious implicit human computer interaction, or conscious implicit human computer interface. Okay, so you are actually giving the command to your system using your own voice. Yes, you can use your body language, you can use the voice, you can use the sign language, something where you won't require to directly touch the system. Okay, or you won't require to touch any input device, whether it is a keyboard or a pointer device. Okay, in such cases, there will be, even if the 1,000 people uses that particular system, no one will get what you can say a fear of getting infected by that system, because system is actually not touched physically by any user. So right now, means if you consider the today's demand of the thing, you can say this is implicit is most important interface that you must have to consider whenever you implement your interfaces. Okay. So this is what I just told you, because before going to the slides, those slides were created and modified in August 2019. Okay, prior to that, around 2014, then 16, 17, these were the updation I made on that, and 19. But now at current scenario or at the present situation, the interfaces we are actually considering, like command line user interface and graphical user interfaces, I myself think must have to be dropped down or must have to be used minimally. And hereafter, every developer in software engineering should and must concentrate on the implicit interfaces like sixth sense technology, gesture recognition, voice commands, and then you can say the non-conscious, what we can say, ports means the observation system that using the WSN, wireless sensor networks, which can observe the environment and likewise, and what we call this as a pervasive computing. So the new interface technology required to be pervasive. This is a beyond syllabus part, which require to be current, so which is actually as per the demand of current situations. And if such type of diseases emerge in the future, more dangerous diseases, in that case, we should and must have to have the machineries which are artificially intelligent and which won't require direct input from the user. Instead, indirect input is sufficient. And even if the input is direct, then that input can be given from a distance without using any input device by the user, either using his voice, his or her voice, either using eye blinking, either using gestures, or either using some other meaning for other means. Okay, so if you understood this, I can go further. Okay, so if you understood this in question answers or in your in this simple thing, you can say okay. Have understood implicit interfaces? These are the advanced interfaces which are not the part of your syllabus right now. But if you won't get implicit interfaces implemented in the future applications, might be all the new softwares that you are going to use in futures will be useless without implicit human computer interaction or interfaces. So if you understood this, or if you got this, you can say okay.